Hills of dirt and stone, folded and furrowed.
That's cool.
Symphony frozen in time.
We don't have to go that way. To visit. You just did.
Save
a lot of money.
A tapestry woven into every shape and pattern imaginable. Until it falls into the sea.
It is in those oceans that life began.
At first, it was simple, drifting with the tides. But it grew and multiplied until the few became many.
And as it multiplied, life changed, taking on many forms.
Every form it could imagine itself to be.
Flocking in swarms and schools, life invented itself, adapted itself.
Some life still drifted. some set down roots.
They're above you.
Clung to the rocks.
Life interconnected into communities. Intermeshed into systems.
It spread itself everywhere throughout the Earth's seas. Shape upon shape. Evolving, adapting, inventing. It stalked and scurried. Hungered and thirsted, it rested and ran. It loved, it yearned.
Look where it's at, yeah.
It killed. was a kaleidoscope of life.
Oh, look at the horses.
And everywhere there was life, soon there was us.
We did that, right?
Blanket that warmed us, the cradle that rocked us.
We paid her homage with all our arts and all our skills and all our devotion. We raised monuments inspired by the monumental glories of our home. Sought to construct a majesty worthy of the majesty around us. To instill an awe that echoed the awesome wonders of our world.
And because we loved her, we wished to know her.
We praised her in every way we could.
Thank you.
until there was no place we could not conquer. No distance we could not span. No heights we could not reach. But we were not satisfied. Our dreams rose higher and we followed them until we left the very ground behind.
Of all the lands and all the seas and all the life we found.
Isn't that pretty?
Scaffold for our own rise. billion dreams, a billion schemes, a billion stories, a billion spokes, each believing they are the center of the wheel. The wells were bottomless. The ores were endless. We dug and cut our way into the earth.
Job for you, honey.
Ignoring every warning. For we had lived upon this land for many years. And everywhere we'd laid our hand, after some brief era, our works collapsed.
Many times. It happened every time. We thought these ruins were only relics of the past, not portents of the future, and so we pushed on.
This time we'd spread so wide, grown so heavy, that when we placed our hand upon the world, it seemed she might never recover.
And everything of beauty we had made, every song that we had sung, every prayer we'd raised, all would be lost. All pale in comparison to our one true legacy. That we destroyed what we had loved.
When all was nearly lost,
we opened our eyes to her tears, our ears to her moans.
Rather than burn our only home down around us, we left of our own accord. We turned off the lights. Gave her space and time to heal. While we perched on the edge of the unknown.
In time, she spread her roots, unfurled once more. Life returned.
And, as it always had before, it multiplied, unfolded, and reimagined itself.
Without us, our nursemaid, our mother and our muse, returned to the garden she once had been.
Briefly, and only by the few.
Stepping with a barefoot touch.
You gotta be kidding me. There you go, hon.
Thank you. universe that we could call a home.
This place you journey to, across many years and countless miles, this place you've landed now is dead.
No, not dead, for it never even lived. But it could.